On the night I was born, the rain was pouring. God was crying, lightning struck, power outage, sparks was flying. The real ones here, the young boy that walked with lions around the outlines of chalk where the corpse is lying.
What it is, it's your boy Joe the Mac.
Juice of Summer, Juice Heffner.
And it's Clutch, man. This is Love and Loyalty, the podcast, man. What it do?
Hey, look, this is a special, special episode.
Yes, yes, man.
One whole year.
One big year, man.
And this is one we're going to review, you know, the pros and cons of doing a podcast. You know, everybody say the goal is, you know, we got to stay consistent, make this shit work.
I ain't gonna say do pros and cons. We're just gonna do a review.
A review with the review gonna be no pros and cons, right?
It's gonna be the shit we learned that we wasn't expecting.
So once again, y'all know what it is. what are your take on this 1 year anniversary?
1 year, bro. Shit, it came up hella fucking fast for real. Like, 1 year came hella fast. You're retarded. But I learned a lot working on the podcast with y'all. You know, motherfuckers' egos and shit like that. A lot of people changed. A lot of people paused, matured. Their mental grew. You know, he like to be on some gay shit sometimes. But
wait till my turn to talk. Ooh, you just fucked up. No, I'm listening. Go ahead. You done?
Yeah.
Man, finish what you had to say, man. Don't let that man throw you off, man.
He ain't throw me off on here. The shit he finna say.
In what ways did you mentally grow?
I like other people's egos. I just said that I mentally...
And then after that, you said you mentally grew.
We mentally grew.
I ain't gonna say they mentally grew.
You think they gonna be the same things from when we started?
Yeah.
You think mindset gonna stay the same? No. You learn more when you talk. You learn when you deal with people. Their mindset ain't gonna be the same from the first day we started this shit about this podcast. It's not gonna be the same.
Let me touch on something real quick, my bad. When you said the ego, like, what you mean by that?
Like, you like you say, you know your people personnel, but people egos change. People change over the years. So as you working with somebody, you see things that you haven't saw before. Just like when you move in with a female, you see things that you didn't see before.
So explain it, though. How did they ego change?
That's what I'm trying to figure out, the ego part, though.
Okay. You always say that you didn't do this talking shit. Mm-hmm. Now you're more open. You're more friendlier to talk to people. Pause. You're more friendlier to talking to people out in public. At first, you just look at motherfuckers like...
All right, so let me say this. My bad, I'm stopping you. That's not an ego thing.
Let me get there before you got
to
say.
My bad, then, too, like the out in public thing. Like, anybody know, my nigga, shout out my nigga, Jay Bate. Bake told me, he said, Juice, I ain't gonna lie, you doing this podcast shit, it's the most I ever seen you talk. How you talk to me, you talk to the niggas you fuck with, but outside of that, no. And this low-key, I ain't gonna say, you right, it got a little better. But I can't just walk into a room with 1,000 strangers, but what's up, my nigga, what's up, dude? Nah, because what I tell y'all all the time, for me, it got energy, based off energy regardless.
Facts, like, people disagree with at that the same time, I seen yeah. that happen, though.
All right, so we'll get back to the ego part.
I seen that happen, though. But back to the ego, like...
See, he's seen the growth.
He's seen the growth.
No, stop playing balls.
Bruh, be wild, G.
It's a pause on him.
Bruh, be wild, G. I didn't say that shit.
I said
it. Bruh, that's like, bruh, be wild, G. Like, bruh. No. Oh, God, he be on some... Bruh, be wild, bro. That nigga's here.
Watch the way you use words, man.
He be saying, like, it's a pause moment.
Pause, nigga! Man, look, don't you ever jump back towards that camera right there. Boy, yeah, nigga,
on that shit. Fuck out of here. Fuck out of here, boy.
Stop playing. I need to hear about the ego part, though.
This dude stay one person about this ego, man. What you see other than the ego?
Nah, hold up, because we got to want to hear this part. I'm for real about the ego. I'm really trying to understand, because that's some shit like I can really probably agree with or disagree. I just want to understand it, though.
Okay, so... A lot of behind-the-scenes shit, motherfuckers don't see is behind-the-scenes, but your ego is like, when we first started this shit, we was all talking, we gonna greet this and that. Fuck out of here, boy. But,
goddamn.
Fuck out of here, boy. Bro, you gotta watch this dude, bro. He gonna bullshit.
All right, man.
But, it's my turn to talk. Why the fuck y'all rushing me for?
I'm all ears. See, I'm just listening. All
right. But anyway, it's like, starting this podcast or 6 months in this shit, your ego changed in my eyes because it's like, let me see. how can I word this correctly?
I know the words you're trying to use.
No, you really don't.
I do.
You really don't.
What are you trying to use? I'm just curious what you think he's trying to, what words is he trying to use?
Let me say this. I think what you're trying to say with the ego shit is like, what, since we started doing it, I don't want to say like, I put the head on type shit where it's like, hey, nigga, I'm like captain type shit. Is that what you're trying to get to?
Because that's ego.
But okay, so let me tell you this. So let's, y'all want to talk facts and be truthful?
I didn't say that you
I'm not saying you did. I'm saying let's be truthful though. I don't change who I am on camera or off camera.
I'm here.
I know that. Me and him had this conversation before, didn't we?
We definitely did.
And I told you, I said, if we're going to keep it 100, I said, man, you trying to low-key reinvent yourself. But with you doing that, you telling me to change who I am for real. Anybody know me, we can walk to a field of 1,000 niggas that know, 50 niggas might know me. Other 75 can know you. This is who I am regardless.
Facts.
To the point, our own group chat, everybody don't know what's up regardless. Like, I don't sit here and in front of camera again, I'm the big dog, the big homie. No, in life, I'm the big dog. I'm the big, I'm not saying like, I'm going to roast some real shit. Like,
real shit.
I ain't saying it about them. I'm talking about in any room I walk in, off of pretty energy, like for real, like that's the way I feel.
That's cool. Like, not, you, but I feel like you're supposed to, though.
I'm here.
That's your mentality.
Man, look, this is the thing. So, look, so once again, our anniversary for a year is April, what, 18th?
Yeah.
I was born April 19th, right? I talked to my mama today. I said, Mama, do you remember when I was born? The day after I was born. I swear to God, I talked to her today. She said, yeah, I remember the night. She said, it was pouring down, raining, fucking storming, lightning, thunder, power outage. Say, nigga, the young nigga that walk with lions. That's the way she described me. And I knew, I was like, that's those facts.
I just
like,
can't wait to see how this motherfucker ended. This
is my matter of fact, I'm lying. And look, I'm about to read the text message because y'all think it's a joke and shit. Y'all think I'll be playing it. Nah. Say, Mama, do you remember when I was born? She said, the night you was born, rain was pouring, God was crying, lightning struck, power outage, sparks was flying. The real one's here, the young boy that walked with lions. Nigga, you see what it say right there, nigga? That's shit my mama.
You ain't pick up on that yet, Bill, bro.
There's fucking facts. So you telling me to sit here knowing that I'm God on earth. Cause that's the way I'm supposed to fucking feel.
Bro, it's me, hilarious,
hold
bro.
Up. You telling me that's the way I'm supposed to feel? You telling me to sit here and minimize my life? For what? Let's keep it fact. Niggas ain't coming to see you, Otis. Let me stop playing. Let me stop playing.
Niggas ain't gonna see you if it wasn't for Otis.
Oh, smart.
This is the thing.
Tell okay, y'all look. Hey, look.
In life, like I said, without the camera, without none of this shit, I'm me regardless.
I'm gonna be seen regardless.
Yeah, I know this, but like, just keep it 100.
I'm saying, but I feel like every man.
And I'm a nigga that don't want to be seen.
You're supposed to be feel like
you're supposed to feel like that, but every man don't. You're supposed to feel like that, but every man don't.
What you say? Every man don't know their worth. We know our worth.
So once again, let's go back to that. You say it's an ego. It ain't an ego. I know I'm the fucking king. I know I'm legit. No bullshit. You throw me in the jungle, I'm walking out that motherfucker with a monkey fur, lion head. Like, and that's how I'm supposed to feel.
So is that the change
again,
of ego?
Again, I never said none of this shit, but so that's how he feels.
Yeah, but I feel like, and I can be real, me being who I am, I'm not ever going to be who I am without the niggas I have around me, though. That's what people understand. I can sit here and say, yeah, if this the mafia, nigga, I'm the godfather. But once again, Luca Brasi, legit, he was a head hitter. He could have killed the godfather whenever he wanted to.
Mm-hmm.
He didn't. The godfather had to legit make sure that nigga was good. He had to make sure everybody around him, like
T-Love said. Like, everybody play a role. You just got to
play a role. That's what love said. You got to build the right
and
team.
And everybody got to play their role correctly.
You have to build the right team.
Everybody ain't a leader, but it's okay not to be a leader. But, like, you can not. I ain't saying like that. Like, you have to learn from somebody in order to in order to be a leader. Like, you got to follow somebody in order to become a leader. So it's okay to follow somebody at times.
And it's crazy you saying that because I feel like I have, in general, like I said, my birthday coming up. Motherfucker made a little collage video and shit for me early. I looked at it and shit. I'm like, damn, legit showing like the growth, like pause. Like legit since I was little to the point where we was running around the neighborhood doing shit. I took a picture, had 5 guns in my hand. All types of dumb shit. I think all of us in the car together.
I'm in the car.
So I was like, it go from that to where I'm at now. I'm not the same person from then. But it took me legit from being back then to being raised the right way back. You know, it'd be my mama, my daddy, my brothers, to having the right people around me, the right team where I can know good and bad, but at the same time, operating the streets, I know how to move, because I ain't just listen to 1,000 crash dummies. I listen to the niggas I know for a fact. It was the niggas, they, you know, move the right way. To the point I learned from them, and now I get my knowledge, yeah.
This nigga said he gets knowledge. Hey, look, I ain't gonna lie, Joe. He's fully self-assured. He's fully self-assured.
Like, I don't think even to say some straight motivation shit, and then that nigga just went left.
It's not left, but these are facts. Like, look, let me tell y'all this. When we drop this episode on some real shit, y'all watch this shit, the people that know us, that see us, from the football field to the gyms, and just in life, the niggas in our group chat that we talk to every day, man, look, tell niggas the truth. This ain't nothing new.
Tell, what's the truth?
I'm like God to these niggas, man. And once again, like, so I'm about to tell y'all, y'all need to show my mama text message again?
Listen,
Joe,
man.
Do I need to show my mama text message
again? It is, nigga, girl.
What'd she say? The night I was born.
She said the night you was born,
the,
man.
Say the rain was pouring.
Nah,
she nigga, what'd she say? The young boy that walked with lions.
You was going to have a hell of an imagination.
Nah, that's a real man imagination. Like I said, y'all got to keep y'all. Look, like you tell me when we had this talk, I be needing niggas just keep it 100. Perfect. Once again, like I said, I'm not me. I'm not making it sound just whatever, but I'm not me without the people around me. And with that being said, I'm not the toughest nigga out of all of us. I know for a fact. We go to the football field. What I tell niggas? Y'all worry about me. I ain't the nigga I need to worry about. I'm like, man, y'all better worry about Lowe. He's like, who? I'm like, Lowe's right there. Lowe's ain't even at the field, niggas looking around. I'm like, shit, y'all better worry about Joe. He calm and he chilling, but I know the niggas I got around me that know I'm the nigga you don't have to worry about. I'm the nigga that's going to instigate them to, yeah, that nigga said this. I'm like, I'm that nigga. I know I'm not, but at the same time, I'm that. But and I'm not that without, like, basically, if this the kind of summing up like this, ended this whole conversation like this. Basically, I'm the dick and they the boss. I'm nothing without my boss. Let me stop pointing.
Oh, man, this nigga.
This nigga hella disrespectful.
No, you gotta understand. This nigga hella. Y'all gotta understand. What is a dick without boss? Like,
man, fuck off.
You're hanging click.
I be just waiting to see how the ending be, bro. And it should be so funny. The nigga be telling stories. That straight be having,
but like that nigga, like,
believe this shit, bro. Like, this is no lie, bro. This nigga told a story one time. We was out of town. This nigga told motherfuckers.
Man, don't tell him. I don't
need
people.
Go ahead. Go ahead.
I said on the episode before.
Oh,
so the story he's about to tell people. And this shit happened to me hell of a ago. And when you watch this, forgive me because I know you don't want to know. So growing up, moved from down from St. Louis. I think it was like now moved to Alabama for like, you know, a little minute. You know, I used to be bad stealing all types of shit. I go to a little corner store, I thought I'd steal some candy, put the shit in my pocket. I'm like, yeah, I might have heard. Motherfucker, catch me.
Check the face, though.
Oh, no, for real. Motherfucker, just caught me. I'm like, what the fuck? I'm like, damn. Get caught. I'm like, man, I ain't gonna be shit. They're gonna be like, nigga, give me that candy. Don't come back in the store. That's what you're doing in St. Louis. My Alabama is different.
What?
Tied me up to the tree.
Damn.
I'm like, they about to fuck me. I look up. I say, all right, here come my daddy. That nigga see me.
So
see
them.
Like, this nigga run away. I'm like, what the fuck in my ass be? I'm like, what to get beat by sticks, these white men with all these devils and shit? I'm like, damn.
So how you feel towards your dick?
Right now?
Yeah, since that happened.
Hey.
So when you went home that night, what you do?
I walked in the house and nigga. I'm talking shit. None of that shit true. But I know that story out of town. Them niggas
when
in the
I park. Say, what? You was straight like, damn, bro, for real?
For real?
Just look at the facial expression, though. The motherfucker never changed or nothing the whole damn time.
I told y'all, like, what, episode 6, that I was a hell of a, one of my hidden talents would be, you know, I'm a hell of a freestyle. I'm not going to say a lie. I'm a hell of a freestyle. Let me say it.
So we the kind of bird off
topic. We most definitely bird off topic. But before we get back on topic, I was talking to somebody earlier. I just want to ask y'all this. I seen on Instagram, no homo. The nigga's legit in Target. That's why I'm going to Target. Shout out Walmart. But we in Target, nigga in Target, he walking up to people like, okay, let me ask you this. He's like, jack your homeboy off.
I just said that. That's
crazy. Mama, dad, like, what are you doing?
It was crazy is I seen one nigga said, jack your homeboy. Oh, it's the same thing, though. I ain't gonna lie to you, man. Shit. Whole mom's had a long time living.
Yeah, my life.
That nigga's crazy. No, I love you.
Nah, look, I'm man.
I love my mom too, but she lived her life.
You don't love her enough. So like I say, that question right there, so reverse it and say, yeah, I kid.
No, listen, like, truth be told, you have honest mom. If it was me, I probably would do it only because I know how I feel not to actually have my mama around, period. You know what I'm saying? So I know how it is to not have a mother, so shit, if it's between this and actually being able to have my mother, then shit, it's just one of the moments I probably would just have to do what I had to do. No homo, goddamn me.
I ain't no homo. Like that shit.
I'm being real.
You telling you your mama dad?
Shit, that's being honest.
Shit, I'm grown now.
Right, so reverse it. So your kids don't lie. They life on the line. You're like one hand too.
I was gonna say some fucked up ass shit. That's what you need to be asking, nigga. You the one willingly jacking a nigga off. Damn, what? Dang, hey, what? Well, bro, I'm with my mom, so I'm gonna jack him off.
The question came about your mother. You fucking idiot. Right. So if I never had a mother, you fucking idiot. So and you think I would willingly let my mama die then, you fucking idiot. I never grew up with having my mama, so without having her, I don't know what none of that is like. So if I got a chance to save her life, nigga, you think I'm not gonna do it?
Yeah, I'm doing it no more.
You a fucking, I'm you an idiot.
I love you.
Yeah, I'm 100%. Yeah.
My thing. Oh, yeah, my see, thing, like, rather than that, whoever got something to say, and they mama did, and they got something to come to me on some different nigga, that way your mama did.
Because truth be told, the question is, yeah, shit.
Yeah, I have been saying, because listen, hey, man, death is a part of life.
Man, I'm saying. It's full circle, my nigga.
That's coming from somebody like you, you know what I'm saying? You had your mama all your life.
But like I said, look, that's
you had your mama all your life.
But
so your ass comes.
I'm saying
it is, you know what I'm saying, and we all go through that shit, but like shit, like for me, I ain't had it, so that's I'm coming for a different.
He said he ain't saving his mama life, but like I said, your kids online.
You'll turn some tricks for the kids at school.
Hey, listen, it's my kids, man.
You're like, laugh them up.
The kids, man.
Laugh them up.
That's my kids.
Right after all that,
that birthday is too, motherfucker.
Everybody in the room gonna die right after that, motherfucker.
Hey, listen, Barris, you talk about that nigga. Birth is too.
Let's get back to the topic, though. Like I said, so what was your take? What's your take on the 1 year of doing this?
It's crazy, like, man, I was straight just having a conversation with somebody. It wasn't even about the one year coming up. It was just about the podcast in general. And, like, just, like, talking to him, he just saying, like you said, like, niggas came from different backgrounds doing a whole bunch, a lot of bullshit to, like, where we now, it's like a positive thing, you know what I'm saying? And a lot of shit that I didn't do before, it made me kind of change myself within just, like, even my timing, I'm always late with every fucking thing I do. Even, see, you might tell me before you outside, I might be 5 minutes coming out the motherfucking door, and I already know you're
10 minutes.
But, like, shit, when it be coming to the podcast, shit, like, at first, at the beginning of this motherfucking shit, I might be 15 minutes late, 20 minutes, you know what I'm saying? But now, shit, for the most part, I'm always on time and ready to rock out. And that's just because I see potential in what we got going on. And it's not just coming from, like me, it's like other talking to other people is what kind of like motivate me to do the shit. Cause like, don't get me wrong now, I want the money, but it ain't about the money for me. It's like shit, it's just like what we doing. We sitting there, we just politicking like every day. You know what I'm saying? It's just normal shit, and people straight really fucking with it. Like he called me actually to ask me a question to ask on the podcast. You know what I'm saying? But I'm telling him, he like, bro, I every Sunday, you nigga, I be tuned in, waiting to see what y'all got to say about whatever y'all saying, you know what I'm saying? Because I fuck with y'all shit, nigga, y'all opening doors for all type of shit, you know what I'm saying? He like, man, what y'all do about getting people on the show? I'm like, shit, matter of fact, you know what I'm saying, you a loyal follower, nigga, you come on anytime you want to, you know what I'm saying? And ask us the questions that you want to ask, because you feel like, you know what I'm saying, what we saying is relevant. And like, shit like that just motivate me to just keep going with the shit, like, you know what I'm saying, and try to better myself in whatever we doing. Like, shit, even, like, I know I could probably do better in everything. Like, I probably don't promote every day. Probably could do that more. shit, I probably like, even, well, whatever we doing, shit, I can always do more of it, you know what I'm saying? So, shit, I see growth in it, and I done seen myself grow, goddamn me, I didn't even seen, pause, look, y'all, I done seen, goddamn me, I didn't even seen, I done seen more out of shit, even y'all, like, shit, I mean, I feel like we all pause, I feel like we all, goddamn me, got more improvement to do, goddamn me, it can do more, but overall, shit, I see it's going to, like, the right direction.
So, let me ask y'all this question. At what point did y'all decide that, all right, this got potential, this could take off, I'm going to get serious?
First day. For me, I'm going to keep it 100.
With me, it wasn't the first day. I ain't going to lie. Like, see, when we first started, it was just because y'all, like, niggas, like, let's do the podcast. I'm like, shit, all right, come on, let's do the podcast. It was something to do. You know what I'm saying? At first, it was something to do. Barryman was doing that shit. I mean, with so that, that shit. With like, that being said,
with that being said, so like we talked about this shit before in plenty of episodes. The motherfuckers always asked, how did we even get started? Like I tell people, it was his idea. Like he legit was like, man, let's do it, let's do it. But my thing is this: he wanted to do it. It was his idea, but he did it off piggybacking because he was like, yeah, man, you know, bro, damn shit, you know, anything, whatever it supposed to be. We can do it better. I'm like, man, I ain't really tripping off of it, but I'm like, shit, you want facts. It? You want it? I thought I told you before. I thought he was lying.
Facts. Like, we sitting in your living room. We had a whole mm-hmm. conversation. We was talking about the podcast about nothing.
Like, I thought y'all niggas was lying too. I ain't gonna lie.
No, we talking about that
he
podcast.
He popped up with the motherfucking Instagram page. That's what, I'm like, damn, this nigga got an Instagram page. All of us on this motherfucking shit.
We was talking about that podcast.
The question you asked, you ain't even asking yourself.
What?
Are you?
I was getting to it.
Go ahead.
It was in his living room. We was talking about the podcast about nothing. And then that's when we went to Josh crib and you told them what was going on with their podcast and shit like that. And I was like, bro, let's start our own shit. Like, bro, we talk about some real life shit that motherfuckers go through. Let's start our own shit. Like, I'm dead ass serious. Nigga like, all right, I'm with it. You know what motherfuckers be like, all right, I'm with it, but I ain't really with the shits. I seen that shit in the nigga face. Like, all right, I'm with it. Go on with it. I said, all right, fuck it.
Go back to knowing your personnel.
Okay, so
went on Amazon that night, bought some shit, came in the mail, waited everything come through the mail. Hey, Juice, you at the crib? Yeah, I'm gonna pull up real quick. Pull up, open the door. All right, let's get this shit going.
I'm shocked. I'm sitting right there, open up the door. See, now that's me. I ain't gonna lie, he opened the door. Me and like five butt naked bitches. I'm like, what the fuck, man?
You always gotta be some shit going on.
I'm like, god damn, man. Why you?
I'm like, damn, you ain't called me and wife. He got five hoses on one. Like, damn, come on, bro.
Nah, they love humans. I'm like, hey, this shit.
Stop playing.
These
bastards.
Hey, so look, this real question, Joe. So back then, when we started this shit, you went and got all the shit and was motivated. Do you feel as though you as motivated as you was then, or are you more motivated now, or like
where
are
you more at? Motivation for this?
You put in. You do you feel like you put that in like towards the podcast?
Yeah, I do.
What about you?
Hell yeah!
I'm asking. I'm saying you.
Hell yeah! This is what I was about to say with that. My man says like this. Like I said, we got our ups and downs with everything we got going on with this show. My thing is this, and I'm gonna keep it 100. I have moments where I always go back to using just examples and shit. So I always use an example like moving a couch. If we had to move a couch through this door right here, I feel like I got one end, I'm moving this motherfucker, consistently trying to move it. Yeah, it's hard for me to move it by myself. You got moments where, let's just say, 50% where you're going to pick this couch up on this end, you're going to push it like, huh, I'm tired, that's enough for right now. Until the motherfucker like, come on, nigga, let's go. Then you pick it up again and move. Like I said, this is my example. Mm-hmm. Like, that's how it is. And like I said, it's been moments, like I said, with Joe, where his moments would be like, hey, I'm here. I bought the couch. I'm here. I'm touching this motherfucker. I'm going to sit down on it. But once again, I'm here. I showed up. So my man said, like, yeah, instead of all three of us giving 100% to move this couch, it's harder because, once again, I'm trying to move the couch. You helping when you helping. And we basically carrying because you here. But you ain't pushing, like, the whole 100% too. And this is just me being honest. It's my opinion. So my thing was like I told y'all the other day, it's to the point if I can give 90% picking this motherfucker couch, or you can give 90. Ain't no way in here this couch is supposed to be across the street, around the world right now.
Yeah, but everybody goes through that phase because you went through it one time too.
Give me an example.
You went through it one time too where motherfuckers, Lil Bill was on the reels and all shit, and I was on the shit, and you was like, man, y'all niggas ain't no shit, bro. I ain't finna do, man, y'all niggas ain't no shit. And you actually left the group chat. You actually left the group chat.
that ain't me going through a phase. That mean I did that because what did I tell you? Did I tell you why I did that? I said I did that because I got sick of telling people the same thing. We said, okay, you supposed to write a contract. You supposed to do reels. I supposed to edit, have this shit done by Wednesday, have it up on YouTube, ready to go by Thursday so you can do your job, right?
Right.
Remember, so, hold on, my bad. Remember I said that, right? And we go from doing that, and I'm like, damn, the contracts ain't ready. But it's 8 in the morning. I see niggas in the other group chat load up, get on the game. Yeah, I'm going to be pissed because, like, shit, I'm doing my part. What the fuck? Like, I'm doing what I'm supposed to do. Nigga, fuck that game. Fuck Call of Duty. Fuck Madden. Fuck that shit. Handle business first. I got in the game and I told you, man, get off this game, bro. Let's handle this shit first. Then we can do that. My man said this. Yeah, I got the same responsibilities y'all got. And I go to work. So to the point where, yeah, I got to do this. And I still making time to make this shit work. And that's what I mean by, yeah, 90%. I'm never going to say I gave 100%. But I know for a fact, hey, come on. Match my energy. Let's rock out.
But this is the thing. What makes y'all think? Did I don't though? I mean, I'm just asking y'all a question because I don't put it in the group chat.
Like, nah, like I said, it's from like that and like I said, conversations to the point. Like I said, if I sit here and say I'm gonna do this, have this on YouTube. What's today? Today's Monday, right?
Yeah.
April 17th. My birthday is Wednesday. Even with my birthday, I'm going out of town Wednesday at 4 a.m. Even with all that going on, I bet you this motherfucker will be loaded up on Thursday morning on YouTube, ready to go. With all that going on, and then once again, I'll go to work today, go to work tomorrow.
See, the difference is, if I put the reel in there, I'm going to post it. So if I put the reel in there, I just don't put it in there for y'all because if I post it, y'all going to repost it. Like, even when I put it in, nobody initially posted their self. Yeah. Everybody repost it or go back and post it. So if that's going to happen, I just don't put them in there. Like, to have it done, like, the shit, like, even when you told me, like, on the game, I told him, like, all right. I already got it done because I be making sure I got it done, but I might not put it in a group chat because I feel nobody loading them motherfuckers up anyway. So I'm gonna load it up then I put the motherfuckers out.
And that's why I tell you I went down to it. That's the low key purpose of a group chat because it ain't nothing but communication. You post like, okay, boo, Jules, I got this motherfucker done. We gonna wait to drop this Thursday. Boo, boo, boo. At least okay, see it. Cause now if Thursday come and there's no real posted at all, I'm like, damn, what the fuck. I did all this shit to edit this motherfucker up, do all this shit. And for what? Because once again, I can take my time and get this shit loaded up on Saturday. I can take my time, live my life, take her to shit. I got to take her other than this, have this shit done by Saturday. But once again, like I said, if I legit sit here, like I said, today, Monday, we sit here today, record this, I have all this shit edited, like I said, with my birthday and everything else coming up, still going to work, doing all of that, and I can have it loaded up by Thursday. Nigga, I guarantee Wednesday night this motherfucker will be on YouTube. All right, so my thing, if I'm doing it,
my day,
and it, but I'm gonna say, if motherfucker don't have to drop,
everybody posts shit, or it be just.
But I'm saying it's a communication thing. That's why
I told y'all this though.
No, I'm saying where if you post it in the group chat, say okay, anybody can drop this Thursday. Even if all three of us drop, we all got our own individual pages. Drop it Thursday. Don't drop it today on Wednesday. Drop it Thursday. Cause once again, I'll help. Book is right here. Even if you don't drop it, I know I can drop it Thursday. Instead of you got in your phone, we don't know what's going on. Then Friday come Thursday, you know, we missed. Like, damn, why you ain't drop it like I did last week? You say, ah, I had to do this with the kids. I forgot. I'm like, okay, I understand. Nigga, that's life. But my thing, if that's in the group chat, even if you busy, I can drop it on my page. He can share it from my page. He can drop it. And it's going to go like that regardless. Because you still did your job at making it.
Yeah, if everybody going to do that, then I put it up, but it just be seem as though nobody post that motherfucker until after. I mean,
nah, even
I
post it, you like, tell
I drop, it, I drop that motherfucker, so. And I like boom, boom. But don't nobody post it. Then I post it. Then it'll get shared. This in the third, so mm-hmm. Me drop it in.
But I'm saying it's like that, you know, he got to tell him. We tell us don't share it, don't drop it yet. You want to do a little tweaking and shit. Yeah. But that's what I mean by that. Like I'm not just doing like on no bullshit. I'm telling like for real, like. If I'm going to give with everything I got going, everything got, like I said, we all got the same shit going, some got more, whatever it is. But if I'm going to move this motherfucking in 90%, if all of us giving the same 90, 100%, there is no way in hell we don't make it. There is no way in fucking hell. And then, like I say, is it going to be hard if one person's pulling the table this way, the other person lifting it, but ain't moving, ain't doing shit, the other person, her touching it. But that's, come on. That's a waste of energy, waste of everything. Everybody put that same energy to, come on, let's go. We're going to rock out, get this motherfucker out of here. And that's what I mean by that. Like I said, and if a nigga legit really sit here and think like, hey, I gave my 90 and I legit, hey, I'm on the same shit, then that's your opinion. But like I tell y'all niggas out of town, I don't give a fuck about words. It's an action thing. Shit, for real, keep it 100. Like, it's action. Like I said, we homeboys for anything.
Facts.
So that's why I said, when you come back to removing myself, man, look, I did that. So once again, we partners. But the same time, shit, it's business. And that's something that I learned from doing this shit over. Like I said, this 1 year of doing it, like people say, man, you should have missed business with your personal shit because that can get messy. And I tell people all the time, man, when we first started, Jessica, what she say, you got to watch the way you talk to your friends. You got, man, look, these my homeboys. Once again, they feel some way. Niggas know where I stay. Pull up, we can fight, slap, whatever we want to do. At the end of the day, y'all my partner still. I'm cool with all of that shit. They won't tell her, like, man, look, don't tell me nothing about my partner. I know my niggas. Like, I'm going to talk to them like we're adults. I'm not babying no niggas.
You shouldn't baby a grown person at all.
At all. But once again, they go back with the first conversation we had. We motherfucker said the ego part. It ain't the ego. It ain't the ego or whatever. These the facts. This is what it is. I'm not saying, oh, yeah, this made me. No, this is what it is before and outside of this life, outside of the podcast, everything. This is legit what it is. That's what I'm saying. It's just holding everybody accountable. Because once again, either I'm getting robbed or y'all robbed. But once again, y'all robbed me type shit to the point. I ain't saying me in general, but just in general. If I'm giving 1,000%, 90%, a motherfucker giving 10% like shit.
Yeah, but see, you can feel like
Call of Duty, baby. You put me in your backpack.
But you feel like a motherfucker only giving 10% if they not showing you the same 90 you showing. You can show. It's all about perspective at this point. You can show motherfuckers you giving 90, and yeah, I can still be doing this 90. I can still be doing this 90, but only showing y'all 10%. That don't mean I'm not giving my 90.
All right, so no, it's not a perspective. You see what work is being done, so that's facts. So I don't know about y'all percentage. I don't know about what y'all percentage that y'all been given. I ain't here to speak on that. But you know what I'm saying, this man who is seeing the work done and the progress, who is a part of the same team that y'all on, he know where the workload is at. And you know what I'm saying, that ain't a matter of perspective. You should see that same workload too. We know LeBron is carrying the workload of his team. You know what I'm saying? It ain't up for debate. So you know where the workload is at.
It's not true.
We know LeBron is the captain of his team. Like, you see he's on the court for 34 minutes.
I don't feel as though there's like, what he feel, I don't feel that I'm not like just lifting the table up though. That's what I'm telling you. I get where you're going with what you're saying.
LeBron,
not saying you wrong with that. I get what you're going with that, but I don't agree with what he's saying. I get what you're saying.
I think I'm more like Jordan-ish. Like, what'd you say the other day? You say, nigga, what'd you tell me yesterday? Why the fuck, how the hell can I battle with? I mean, I'm like, Jordan. I can battle with a high school bench player. You know what you told me yesterday?
Nigga more like Alonzo Ball.
This nigga told me that yesterday. Huh? He said, nigga, I'm Jordan. How the fuck is like me arguing with a high school bench player? That's what you told me yesterday.
So, the reference that he used is, you know saying, irrelevant. If you don't like that reference, you still got to understand where the workload, you know saying, the balance of this workload. Do you feel like the workload is, you know saying, leaning heavier on his end than it is on yours?
What I'm saying is I feel as though I'm doing what he's doing is what I'm telling you. So you asking me, that's what I'm telling you. I feel as though, like,
okay,
I can, if displaying it in a group chat or whatever is what need to be done, that could be done. But that's just going to show that I've been doing right what I said I was doing the whole time.
Then that's part of the workload.
Nigga, I show it. What are you talking about?
I'm saying that if he just talk about the lack of communication, like, if you got something done, say it. If you busy, say it. Like, you know what I'm saying, that's still a part of the workload as well, to know, you know what I'm saying, what is being done. The real is your department. And he's unsure if your department is being done. This is your department. You run that shit. Let it know that, man, I got my end handled. Like, here it go. I need to, you know what I'm saying, when I get this done, make sure y'all do, you know what I'm saying, once I'm done with this, make sure y'all do this and that. You tell them what to do when it comes to
this. I told her.
We had conversations. Like I said, when it connected to this whole year thing, like I said, on the camera end, y'all see the shit, I look flawless. But no, I'm just talking about like committed, you know. I'm saying, like, we had with this shit, like I said, it's legit a real business. Like I said, we had meetings where it's us three. Got meetings where my cousin, my brother, all the homeboys there, and they legit giving us input to the point of shit that I was completely wrong about it. Niggas say, oh, yeah, I gotta stop saying it's your boy, oh yeah. I'm like, nigga, we don't say that shit. I ran the camera, that nigga sung me a whole thing. I'm like, damn, that nigga right. Damn, Sean, you right. And like I said, I called him like, yeah, bro, you right, I'm wrong. Like, but that's what it takes. Once again, it's nothing but criticism. Nobody's ever saying nothing to hurt nobody's feelings. Everybody, that's not what I'm saying. I'm saying everybody's legit putting their input in because everybody see the bigger picture. Everybody see the bigger picture. That's why I say when it comes to certain support, I have motherfuckers for like, okay, we got a group chat, it's 15 niggas in our group chat, only one really shirt of shit every week, two shirt of shit every week. To the point niggas like, man, they ain't supporting, they gotta wait till we blow up. And I tell you, I don't look at it that way. I don't, it's
everybody support
word.
Differently.
Yeah, like I say, niggas, hey, everybody got lives. Once again, they ain't stopping niggas from not being my partner, nothing, nah. This is what it is. They gonna call, tell us that when niggas lacking, when niggas ain't got shit together, niggas fucking up, and they gonna still call, give us the praise. Like, no, that was a hell of an episode. Y'all doing your thing.
But
you guys, you the brain, huh?
No, they ain't saying nothing. But they gonna call and give us like, oh yeah, y'all doing shit. That's the episode. But this is what I saw, and we take heed to that shit. We listen to that shit. We make the adjustments that we need to make.
Sometimes. I told you gotta turn your sensitivity button and we had these talks. Remember what Teron came and said, he said play a role. He say people come here that he don't be understanding. A lot of people do watch our shit to look like Joe. And niggas be like, what? But for real, what did Teron say? He said, man, you gotta understand you got a great position right now. You in a position where if they come to watch you say something dumb, they still watching you. He said, they chew what I tell you last time, like seeing a pal of dog shit. You can choose to walk around it or you can step through that motherfucker. They choose to step in that dog shit, that's on them. But once again, we not mad. Keep watching. Like, he's not going to every episode.
That's so fucked up, bro.
I ain't going to lie about the last every episode. He's not going to say something dumb.
That's so goddamn dumb.
I ain't saying that. But shit, like, he's like, hey.
He says nigga who hit a heart attack last episode.
Hey, look at this nigga.
Ain't got nothing to move with dumb shit or ego either. Goddamn me. <shit. laughs> You want to talk, let's talk about this ego situation and what that means. But let's like get on to something else.
Yeah, but with this shit, like I said, we got to, you know, like I say, man, it's ups and downs like it is in life in general. And, shit, like I said, this situation helped me, shit, learn my, like I said, I'm big on knowing my personality, but this situation most definitely helped me learn niggas more in a business sense to the point you spend all day, every day with these niggas, you going to start saying shit to the point where I question, like, call cuz, like, damn, man. Bro, ain't all the way there, is he? Because, like, Ben told you that. I'm like, fuck. Man, I ain't know that shit. I know this nigga was, but damn, I'm learning something new every day. And they say you're supposed to learn something new every day type shit. But, like, so we understand we got shit to work on. We ain't perfect. We ain't even close to 25% of shit the potential. Like, for real, we right now, we still in this room right here. We gotta bust through this ceiling and make it where the fuck we need to make it at. Like, for real, on some real shit.
See, you gotta think, bro. It's all been a progress. We started off where?
In the basement.
Shit, in the basement.
City, the basement.
Goddamn me, then, like you said, it's support shit. Bro, goddamn me, got us in this location we in now. Right before that, somebody else had, you know what I'm saying, put us in. We ain't doing nothing but progress, and even with the steps we going with now, see, with the location and everything.
Let me ask y'all, because we did an episode that we didn't drop because, you know, whatever, we got a lot of shit going on. Let me ask y'all a question that I asked on that episode. So you going to answer? You going to answer for me? You going to answer for me, and I'm going to answer for you. If y'all was superheroes, what would y'all kryptonite be? You answer for Bill, you answer for me, I answer for
you. You're going to let Bill go first.
Go ahead. What would my kryptonite be?
I don't think you got one, man. I don't think this nigga got one. Fuck out of here, dude.
Man. What my kryptonite be, man? Don't say what I think what you said last time, because I ain't gonna lie. Mother be popping up in my house tripping and shit, so. Yeah, check that me stop playing.
It's the truth, though.
That's what you say then.
It is the truth, though.
What do you think it is?
Kryptonite?
Yeah.
Females.
Agree or disagree? What about you? What do you think this kryptonite is?
Strong Bill going with you before?
Nah, yeah, always with you. Nah, come on.
Let's go answer.
You answer for Bill.
Joe want to know what's his kryptonite?
Yeah, I know what you finna say.
I'm not saying it no more because I see the way you reacted last time.
I know what you finna say.
So I'm gonna see what you think his kryptonite is. Cause last time you said what? Sports cars?
Yeah, but I ain't gonna go with sports cars. I'll go with time management.
Yeah. So it's on me?
Yeah.
Mirrors.
I can't wait to say this shit.
See, look, last time he didn't understand. So he keep on saying,
what's that? My real kryptonite, Joe. Yeah, Joe, tell that nigga.
A strong black woman?
Yeah, that's his real kryptonite. Hey, a strong black woman.
Come on, baby. Bless me. Hey, where you at, baby? Hey, get my kryptonite. I love y'all.
Hey, Joe, I ain't gonna lie, man. I thought you was finna kill this nigga, Paul. I ain't gonna lie. I thought you was gonna.
See, look, see, he just tried to look. See, this thing. I was about to hit the whole why I said mirrors, but no, you wanna play.
I ain't gonna lie, I thought you was finna line your ass up, Paul.
See, he walked into a room full of mirrors, boom, to dust. Like vampires, he's something like that nigga Blade, that nigga's out of there, boy. I'm telling you, room full of mirrors will put you the fuck down. But it ain't because of what you think I want to say.
I get a mirror every day, so that don't mean
cap.
Ain't no
cap. It ain't because of what you think.
Strong black woman, you can't handle that.
I can handle multiple. But it ain't, like I say, so what I mean by mirrors, I'm not saying because the way you look, because once again, all you niggas are ugly to me.
You damn right, y'all.
Like, what you tell me, cuz, ain't no nigga ever scarred you cute.
Yeah.
He told me that. I'm like, facts. So to the point, I don't care what a nigga say about me. The reason I said mirrors for you, cuz the only person who can stop you from going where you need to go is yourself. So when you look at your reflection, it's scaring you, staring back at you like, nigga, you're stopping yourself.
Dude is so full of shit, y'all.
So once you make it past the peekaboo stage, like, you're out of there. I watched her when we ran this one back in the beginning of this episode. He jumped through the phone.
You said he just got to be real with himself, and that's it.
Be real with yourself. You start speaking your truth, living your life. Yeah, like, don't worry about them. Like I say, fuck this. You know what you is. Be comfortable with who you is. The mirror should not be a thing
bro,
that you run away
from. That sound right, bro.
What is it?
You start speaking your truth, bro.
I'm talking about the mirror. Oh, man, see.
All right, so go ahead, reverse it, man. What's your superpowers? Everybody.
My superpowers?
No, you can't tell your own superpower. You know, say, so yeah, I got to do it the same way.
Oh, okay.
He got to tell you. It's like, what's your superpower? You know, say, so go ahead, reverse it.
All right, Joe's superpower? All right, but I'll reverse it. I heard stories about Joe back in the day. It's a nigga, tongue guy.
Bro, we on so much bullshit, bro.
My nigga TJ said, he called my nigga Lickologist. Let me stop playing.
Oh, no, I ain't
gonna lie. Nah, let me stop playing.
I ain't gonna lie.
I ain't gonna call it a pop. It's like a, I'm gonna say a trait. He dependable as a motherfucker. I'm gonna keep it him. Like, the nigga most definitely solid and dependable as shit. Like, no bullshit. Like, back against the wall, I know for a fact who I can call and straight, I'm good to go. If it ain't my brother, it ain't my cousin, I know this nigga legit gonna show up regardless. I can be on the other side of town. And I promise you, I call this man, he pulling up with whatever. I always been like that.
I agree with that. You? Nah, you getting a little too cocky, motherfucker. Your superhero is just the ability to tell a story.
Man.
Hey. Because, like, even like the story he just told, man, we was out of town, that shit was so funny because it was niggas like, damn, bro, for real, your daddy straight left you, bro? Man, that's fucked up. Man, you can
shit
tell.
Definitely a gift.
Yeah, you can tell the way they saying it. Like, nigga, they really mean that they really believe this nigga.
I was going to
tell
them niggas why I stopped going to church, but that's some, that shit.
Man, I ain't going to lie. I'm sitting there like, damn, this nigga's like, man, bro, that's crazy, man. You never know what people go through and shit. That's crazy, bro. I would never thought you did this shit. I'm looking like this nigga, boy, yeah. And that motherfucker sound believable, though.
Should be fun.
All right, let's build.
His strength.
He can drive.
No, I'll say he got a lot of connections. He know how to use his connection when he needs to. He got a lot of connection. That's one of his strengths. Because, like, he brought us T-Love. T-Love brought us...
He's a superhero. What is your power?
No, I said strength. I didn't say powers. But being dependent is not a power.
That's why I changed and I said, well, to me, I'm going to say that's a trait. That's why I said it before I answered
it. And then that's when I said one of his strengths are he's...
So nobody really answered the question but me is what y'all just
get to. Like I said, his superpower... Run through brick walls. He's gonna be. I'm not saying it's a bad. You're taking like he's a thing or something. No, I'm saying like he's gonna be up, there. Bro. That's what I mean. Bro, no, so I'm for real. Like bro. Super strength is basically what I'm saying. Bro, that would be your superpower. He's gonna be there regardless. He's dependable.
I mean, I get where he's going with it. I felt both.
You see, you know what I'm saying? Your superpower is, you know what I'm saying? You're Mr. Reliable. You resourceful.
He just used to being the ass of a joke, and he just take compliments. Let me stop.
See, that's a kill part right there. That's
I'm joking.
Say any compliment.
Come on, that's joke. This nigga always come with a grain of a compliment and 10 pounds of salt behind it. He's gonna give you a little compliment, but he's gonna talk a bunch of shit so you won't hear the compliment.
You ain't a slug. It ain't gonna kill you. You'll be okay, Gary. You'll be okay.
Bruh ain't shit. Ain't shit at all. Bruh is legit. Ain't shit, bro. I'm telling you, this nigga ain't shit. But back to the question at hand. Your superpower will be...
Wheelman.
Say speed.
Driving.
Speed. I mean, he more than just a wheelman. He more than just speed. Boy, he'll useful. He'll be like a utility knife. He could be the thing that changes other shits. That'd be a superpower. He could camouflage real good.
You thought the thing was bad. He should call you Josh.
I'm really trying to figure out where he was going with that motherfucker. Hey, look, at first, it's first when I was trying to spin it to like, okay, I can see, you know what I'm saying? I can see where he's going with this. This other, this. You went to like four different things and just threw me all the way. Like, left. Because
You camouflage. You're good with it. You fit in with crowds, you know, being unseen until it's time to make your move. Ain't nothing wrong with that.
What? Nigga, who being unseen?
What you saying?
This nigga, when I first started hanging around y'all niggas, whatever, and I'm not lying, when I first started hanging around, anybody that know this nigga know he was a clubbing-ass nigga. Clubbing-ass nigga. Sure. I used to pull up. You know, this one, like I said, coming so back then, nigga was outside.
I don't understand.
I swear to God, I'm like,
I ain't on this.
But this thing.
I ain't on this.
You better when I met the niggas.
I ain't even know who the fuck he was.
When he broke your ankle, that's when.
I'm saying that's when he was playing football. He rolled on my ankle. Let's clarify that. He rolled this nigga about.
I'm saying we met at the same time. I'm meeting niggas. I'm like, yeah, what's up, bro? You know, we everybody cool and shit. Talk to cousin. Like, no, this my people. I'm like, all right. You jamming, motherfucker. Like, come on, let's go out. And you know me, going out the club, I don't fuck with clubs. I go out, you already know, I don't want to be seen. I'm going to say what's up, sit in the back somewhere, just ducked off just in case some bullshit pop off. Me with these niggas. I'm like, all right, this whole squad of these niggas. I'm like, all right, bet we outside. I'm over in the cut. What the fuck these niggas doing? They on stage?
Hey, look, this story
was cool. What the fuck going on?
This nigga keep making me think about this other shit. He's talking about motherfucker this
chameleon.
Yeah.
Cause he said, he's talking about he blending into the crowd. That's how I got to. I'm like,
he is out.
Tell these niggas, like, man, y'all got beef. Get the fuck off the stage.
I'm me regardless of who I'm around. I ain't blending this shit. I don't know what you talking about. I'm going to be me. I ain't becoming this other nigga to fit in this crowd and then pop.
I didn't say that. I didn't say that at all. All
right, so look, let me ask y'all this thing. We're going like this. What do y'all, all of us gonna answer? What do y'all feel like as an individual, y'all can do better to make this shit, make the goals work?
Me as an individual, what can I do better? Mm-hmm. Shit, man.
Zoom in on me.
I mean, I'm doing shit. Everything right. I'm thinking what I could do better. Shit. Probably talk more on the show. Tell my story from the past. Shit like that.
Cap, man.
Look, we gonna call Cap about me because everybody can do everything better, bro. Like, don't nobody promote every day. Don't nobody find us guests. Everyone, we do all this. I'm saying,
no.
This is okay. Even these things as well.
But answer the question.
I am. These things are things that I know I can do better for the podcast, nigga. Like, I don't, let's say if we scale it 1 to 10, I don't promote at a 10 every day. You know what I'm saying? I don't reach out to people to come on the show every day at a 10. I can say that. Even if we emailing companies for sponsors, if we emailing people for sponsoring me, being real myself, we got 7 days in a week, I might send out maybe 6-7 emails throughout the week. I could send that more. I can goddamn me probably use my connections like Joe was saying. I could probably use that more. Like it's always room for improvement. That's what I'm saying is it's cap. Like ain't nobody doing nothing at 100%. Like that's just being real, nigga. Ain't nobody, none of us promoting at 100%. So you can always improve with that if you just saying that.
Are you sure about that?
You promoting at 100%. So right now on the camera, you can show me that you, before you walked in here, at 100%. That means, nigga, all this week you done promoted the episode all this week.
Today Monday.
The last episode.
I'm like, damn, thing that I show you.
Oh yeah, today Monday. Let's go last week. So that means he dropped it on a Sunday. So that means I went Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. Week. Thursday,
Friday, Saturday. Okay, so last week, I showed this motherfucker.
Let me ask you, is sharing the only way we promote?
No, I DM too. I go in my football group chat right now. And they were like, damn, why you dropped the episode yet? I said, I did drop it, y'all missed it, but I'll drop it again. Y'all go for y'all miss it. So I go to all my inboxes, football chats and say this shit.
Can you show me in the inboxes you promote? You send them out Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Saturday.
I don't send them out on Sundays. I send in inbox, I send them on Sundays, but I share them on Mondays.
I send that shit. Everybody, like my Facebook friends, y'all gonna see this shit. Look, leave comments. Y'all know. Nigga see me at the football scene. He say, nigga, Clutch always send this shit to my DM. I said, I'm hip. I said, if he don't, I know I'm posting that shit to the point where we send it to the same people. I see you send people on Instagram. I'm like, I already sent to him.
Motherfucker be like, see, hey, like, I already got to somebody else in y'all shit. Like,
I'm like, yeah, I ain't gonna lie.
That's
like,
what I mean by promote. Even like shit, nigga, like you had the business cards. We ain't even finished. We ain't never get the business cards. So putting the business cards everywhere. We don't do that shit. Like it's always ways, more ways to promote. So ain't nobody doing that at 100%.
Fuck the business. You know what I'm saying? Shout out Doc Core. That's what I get. So I've been using that or whatever. But how you doing, son? I've been using that or whatever. And like I said, my thing, like I said, we ain't at 100%. I know what I can
do. And what I'm saying is, Joe, don't think that I'm just saying this to you. I'm saying,
I know you say
everybody. I'm saying everybody in general, I feel as though everybody can do everything.
So my thing
is, nobody doing it at 100% what I'm telling you.
Yeah. So my thing, I know what I can improve on. Like you said, nobody's doing it 100%. One thing I know for a fact I can really improve on is cracking that whip on these niggas some more. But y'all know what it is, man.
This love nigga crazy.
Y'all
know what's up. I guess I just got to crack the whip a little more.
He need patience.
Y'all know what it is, man. Love and loyalty to the podcast, man. Leave comments, subscribe, share, do everything. We most definitely check the comments on YouTube. Shout out to Doc Horse. Shout out to Manscaped. Hey, I see what it is. She got the sponsors. Like I say, what's the code? LRL3.
LRL3. Get your 20% off.
20% off. Shave everything up. Once again, this is Love and Loyalty, the podcast. Juice Heppner, OG Juice Osama.
It's your boy Joe the Mac.
And it's Clutch, man. The man who needs no introduction. Let's get it.
Y'all know what the name of the bars. Let's get it.
Awesome trying to revive a sport that's dying. But the guns and the drug bars that y'all relying. Got these nerves.